So, Dad, we need an adult chaperone to go on a high school trip to Helene Honduras. She was getting married later that summer. I thought, what a grand opportunity to spend some time with my daughter. So I willingly agreed. Just before we left for Honduras, there was a meeting the night before, and the youth pastor said, oh, by the way, I want everybody to know that I want Scott to have final choice and responsibility for this trip. Suddenly, I went from being a tag-along dad to being a mission trip leader. Gee, thanks, Spence. As we were preparing to go, the high school kids were certainly caught up in the excitement of graduating. And very few of them were willing to pray out loud, and that concerned me. But once we arrived on that small, poor island of Helene, they were wonderful and on point. We had projects such as rehabbing an islander's house, building a floor for a new classroom, doing vacation Bible school in five villages, cleaning up garbage, doing sports camps, and going door to door to meet and greet the villagers. Within days, all these kids were praying out loud with themselves, with the islanders. They were doing devotions. They were leading youth services. They did a fantastic job. I believe most of them came back with a real passion for missions and a good understanding of their spiritual gifts. When I returned, I became part of a team called Team Helene. And there's seven members of this church that are committed to having other people have a Helene experience. To date, over 250 people from our congregation have gone down to Helene. This is the 11th team to go, be commissioned by Sunset, and team number 12 is happening this summer in June. For me personally, going to Helene changed my relationship with Christ. Every day, I so felt his presence and love. He freed me up to be able to worship him more fully. All my spiritual gifts seemed to connect at one point in time. And for the first time in my life, I felt that he actually knew my name, and he had spiritual opportunities for me to serve him. Since that trip, I've been able to go to Helene on six different mission trips like this one. And each time, there are relationships that are built. And now I have a family, an extended family of islanders who are very dear to me. During this service in the coming year, if you hear about a mission trip that just tugs at you, I want to encourage you to consider that God's calling. Let me assure you, there are countless locations and ministry opportunities in the United States and around the world that desperately need people like you and me.